Hello everyone, and welcome to The Sims Lore. This week, we're exploring the Pleasant family. Last week, we took a look at the Burbs, who are connected to the Pleasants. This is a family full of lore, so it's going to be quite long, you guys, so sit back, relax, and enjoy. Let's get into the video. Let's start with the beginning. We touched on Jeff and Diane Pleasant last week when we spoke about Jennifer Burb. So let's look at them a little bit closer. Jeff Pleasant is the son of Les Pleasant and Kina Pleasant. They don't seem to appear in The Sims, but they appear as ghosts in The Sims 2. Interestingly, to me, Jeff's parents' names sound kind of strange. Les Pleasant sounds like Les Pleasant, and Kina's full name sounds like Kind of Pleasant, which might mean that Jeff's parents weren't that nice. Jeff's wife, Diane, is a housewife and takes care of Daniel and Jennifer in The Sims. So let's have a look at Daniel Pleasant. He appears as a child in the first Sims game along with his sister Jennifer. They both have the same bios, which read, Daniel or Jennifer and his or her family are new to the neighborhood. Can you help him or her make new friends and succeed in school? In The Sims 3, Daniel is a newlywed young adult living with his wife Mary Sue in Sunlit Tides, where they are enjoying their honeymoon. His bio reads, this island is fantastic, beautiful beaches and great fishing. Daniel is athletic, charismatic, flirty, great kisser, and has commitment issues. This is a recurring trait or wish for Daniel, as we'll come to see next. Moving on onto The Sims 2, Daniel and Mary Sue live in Pleasant View with their twin daughters, Angela and Lilith. Their family bio reads, on the surface, Daniel and Mary Sue Pleasant seem to have the perfect life, but is their love a flimsy facade? And can Angela and Lilith make the right choices when it comes to love? Daniel's bio reads, since his father Jeff died without achieving his dream of going to Mars, Daniel has felt an overwhelming guilt. We know that Jeff Pleasant had a dream of being the first Sim to walk on Mars, however, this was never accomplished according to Daniel's bio. As mentioned in last week's video, Maxis was developing a game called Sim Mars when they first released The Sims, although it was cancelled due to the overwhelming positive response to The Sims. However, many speculate that this whole backstory of Jeff and Daniel is a mention to Sim Mars. Daniel works as an assistant coach in the athletic career and he has the romance aspiration, which makes a Sim want to have lots of woohoo with several different partners. He is enemies with Angela's boyfriend, Dustin Broke, and doesn't like her dating him. He hasn't yet met Lilith's boyfriend, Dirk Dreamer. Daniel Pleasant is also having an affair with Kaylin Langerak, the maid, but Mary Sue doesn't know it yet. Daniel and Mary Sue's relationship is really poor as they're not in love nor best friends at the start of the game. He also appears in The Sims 4 with Mary Sue, Angela and Lilith as a Max's official recreation available in the gallery. And of course, even in this alternate universe, Daniel is a non-committal Sim. So let's have a look at Mary Sue and her family. Mary Sue was adopted as a toddler, and her adoptive parents are Herb and Coral Oldie, available in The Sims 2 family bin. Their memories show that they had woohoo before they adopted Mary Sue, which might mean that they were trying for a baby but couldn't conceive. I used to play with the Oldies, and what I found really sweet is that Herb and Coral can celebrate their golden anniversary when the game is first played. Herb's bio reads, if being a crafty businessman, loving father, and reasonably reliable husband takes a lot of energy, then Herb Oldie has led an exhausting life. Just like Daniel, Herb also has the romance aspiration, but has never been unfaithful to Coral, nor does he have the negative memories of engagement and marriage. It also appears that Herb might have been fired or quit from his business job rather than retire, but if he rejoins the business career, he can start at level 5 as an executive. Coral's bio reads, as the picture of maternal perfection, Coral has raised a successful, beautiful daughter, but at what price? In her character files, she has a hidden popularity aspiration token, which explains the bio and the aspiration she had to leave behind to raise Mary Sue. Let's take a closer look at Mary Sue. She and her family don't appear in The Sims, but both her and Cassandra Goth have memories of being friends since childhood, so it's possible that the Oldie family moved to Neighborhood 1 after the start of The Sims. She appears in The Sims 3 alongside her husband Daniel as newlyweds in Sunlit Tides. Her bio reads, what a wonderful island. I love the deep blue sea and the lush green of the jungle. Now moving on to The Sims 2. Her bio reads, active and friendly, Mary Sue believes people are inherently good. She enjoys pottery or used to when she had the time. Interestingly, even though her bio says that she is friendly, Mary Sue is actually quite grouchy. She works as an intern in the politics career and is a workaholic, as her bio says. She has no time for anything except working. When the family is first played, the game is coded in such a way that Daniel has a day off while Mary Sue goes to work and the twins are in school. Kaylin Landrak comes over as the maid and soon finishes her chores, asking Daniel if he'd like to hang out. Mary Sue will get a chance card at work, where either option will result in her being sent home early, so if the player chooses to have Daniel woohoo with Kaylin, Mary Sue will catch them in the act. It's also possible to have Daniel clean up before Kaylin arrives so that she finishes her job early and they can woohoo before Mary Sue gets home, letting him get away with the cheating. But where's the drama and fun in that? Alright, moving on to the teens. Let's start with Angela. Her bio reads, "Angela is patient and dutiful. She dreams of being a fishing boat captain." Angela is a B student and is dating her childhood friend Dustin Broke. She's considered to be the nice twin and has a 20 out of 20 relationship with her parents, except for her twin, who is her enemy. Angela's name is also derived from Angel, while her twin's Lilith is the name of a demon, meaning of the dark, in Jewish mythology. Angela was also potty trained and taught how to walk and talk, while Lilith was not. Okay, now on to Lilith. Like mentioned before, she's the complete opposite of her sister. Lilith is a D-minus student, and it's speculated that Lilith's relationship with her family decayed from the fact that their parents favored Angela over her. Her bio reads, "Lilith had it harder than her twin sister, so she says." Which, you know, just isn't fair. Lilith is dating Dirk Dreamer. Funnily enough, neither twins have much in common with their boyfriends. Angela is a really good student, while Dustin is more interested in crime, and Dirk is a really good student, focusing on business and getting into private school, while Lilith is a terrible student. Most players prefer to break them up, and I've even heard of players switching Dustin Broke with Dirk Dreamer. What do you guys think? Have you guys done this? I have before, and it does make more sense for Lilith to be with Dustin and Angela with Dirk. But again, where's the drama and fun in that? Alright, so there you have it guys, lots of info on the Pleasants. Let me know how you ended up playing with this family.
I'd like to thank my patrons Anastasija Kuzminaite, I'm sorry if I'm pronouncing that wrong, and Cal Fenton. And I want to thank you all so much for your continued support to this channel. It really means a lot to me.
That's it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it, and let me know your theories in the comments below. Follow me on Twitter for more lore. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!